Welcome back, everyone, to HPI Guys Workshop. We are going to be building up the all-new, brand-new molds, completely new from front to back, Trumpeter 1/72nd scale American LaFrance Eagle Fire Pumper. Yes, a company from outside the U.S. is producing models of new U.S. fire engines. Isn't that kind of interesting? That's pretty cool. So otherwise, if you want to get a fire engine kit, you usually have to buy the 1/25th scale models from Ravel that are a Snap-Tite or AMT, which are beautiful kits and build into very large, beautiful machines, but are older molds and quite difficult to put together. They are extensively for more experienced modelers. This one, being less than 70 parts total and in 1/72nd scale, should not be as difficult to put together or as time consuming. This has been sent over by Model Rectifier Corporation, who has this kit in stock right now. One thing to remember when you buy a kit from Model Rectifier Corporation, the U.S. distributor of Trumpeter products, they will give you parts support. Now, when you buy this from another online retailer, Trumpeter usually makes you go through them, and because they're overseas, you get a heck of a long time to wait for some stuff. But Model Rectifier wants you to know that they provide parts support for the kits they sell. So if you buy from them at the link I provide in the description, or just go to their website, you don't have to use the link I provide. I don't make anything off of that. So however you want to get to Model Rectifier Corporation, when you buy from them, if you're missing parts or have issues, which is very rare with Trumpeter kits, but if you do and you provide them with your receipt and proof that you purchased from Model Rectifier Direct, they will provide parts support and help you out instead of like all the other dealers, which say, hey, sorry about that, good luck, buddy, see if you can get a hold of Trumpeter and replace a part. So we're going to be building up this little beauty today. It's got all kinds of details for a kit this small. So let's start taking a look at the parts when you get yours. We've got a clear glazing tree here. We've got the wigwags on the roof, the two littles and the big. The big one, I think, is towards the front of the cab, and the little wigwags are towards the back of the cab. Then we have our windshield glass, and even in 1/72nd scale, it is quite small. We've got all of our side lights. I like that these are a little larger and they mount in with these clear strips between the door panels so we can get those on there. The windshield actually has a raised edge that allows you to do your black markings around the edges. So that will make things a little bit easier. Going into paper goods, an excellent color guide. This is pretty much life size for the model, because it's 1/72nd scale, so you can see the colors that things should be, where all the decals should go, and then they've got paint references, and all the ones they give are the major brands, and then you can use online references if you're worried about having exact colors. Now, since I don't show a lot of Trumpeter kits on the show, I will show you one of their manuals. It's very standard. You get your parts overview with all your parts trees, and then you have your standard assembly going on like so. So you can see the seats. The seats are actually here on the trees with all their frames. They're pretty cool looking. Then it tells you to put in the glass. Now, because of this being from Trumpeter, a lot of the stuff they will instruct you to do is more similar to the way they would have you build a military model. Now, I'm going to build this up like a car modeler because that's my main audience. So we'll be taking a look at my techniques and see how they work. Also in this, something you may not be very familiar with is a photo etch fret. And this is brass etched out with a chemical process. On this kit, because it is 1/72nd scale, it's got just a little bit here. These will be walls in the hose racks in the back. So these will separate the hoses. They're very thin. If they molded that in plastic, they might be a little thick. And then this is the diamond plate on top of the front bumper. This right here. This separate diamond plate piece off that large front bumper is what you are getting in that photo etch fret. Usually you buy these aftermarket. These things are like 20 bucks alone. So that included in the kit. Then we have the most adorable set of six tires. They are a soft vinoplastic. The wheels go in from one side on these ones, and they actually have tread. I'm not going to, maybe I'll sand these, but I don't think so because they're mostly hidden underneath the truck. There are no name brands on these, but they do actually have grooving on the sidewalls even. So outstanding work on those six little tires. Make sure you don't lose those. We've got a set of window masks, and that's if you decide to place the glass in and then paint the body and two-tone it. That's what those window masks are for. Since the body goes on last and the interior goes in, I'm going to try to get away with putting the glass in last and then the interior. We've got a nice set of decals. What I liked seeing in this is the gold, white, black that they have on the bottom of the body is done in a decal. Whew. This can be hard enough to mask off that cab without trying to put this huge amount of color decal on the bottom. Then we've got a lot of gold logos, engine numbers, door logos in gold, American flag, stuff like that on there. So all important to have. Nice little water slide decal sheet for the kit. We will now move over to the white styrene. We've got two parts trees, as you can see. We've got this one, take it, that's your front axle. There's your steering wheel, my fingernail. I have almost double X hands. XL gloves fit very tight on me, so you can get an idea. That is about 3/4 of a centimeter across, I think, just about on that steering wheel. We've got very small detail parts. Check out the mirrors. But even in this scale, they didn't make the mirrors pedantic. They're just a nice size, and they should mount onto the body without issues. We've got our leaf spring packs. We've got pump parts, air tanks, fuel tanks for the frame. A lot of this stuff we'll be able to get together as we assemble it before we paint it. Some of the stuff we won't. On the second parts tree, we've got our nice seating. We've got our wheels, check it out, molded open. Which means if you do get too much paint in there, you can simply poke those out with a pin. You don't have to try to drill anything. Our full exhaust system on this kit, aluminum ladder, interior of the cab. We've got our exterior with fabric rolls on the side. Actually, nice detail on those. Rear leaf spring pack. Dashboard. So we'll hand detail some stuff on the dashboard. I didn't see any decals for that, but maybe those were provided. So we've got that one parts tree there. You can see all the panel lines are a little accentuated, a little deeper being in this scale. They're harder to see once you get paint on everything. So they work that out. They do a lot of stuff in the small scales. Check out this frame. All one piece, which I'm very happy to see. Got our drive shafts, transmission, differential in the rear, front bumper with molded in vents in 1/72 scale. So when people are making 1/25 scale stuff and modern molds and they can't add the detail they claim, that they're not really being honest with us. All the fine holes molded into the frame to mount our tanks and our air tanks, chassis components, even little rivets and details on there. So the rivet counter should be pretty happy. We've got one of our sides, another side, and that one actually opens and you can see fire extinguishers inside. That's pretty awesome. Very, very surprised on the detail inside there. We've got the back of the truck where they store the hoses, the ladder hooks, be very careful. We've got all of our equipment and mounting holes on there. Even our handles are molded in on this one. And I like that because I can accentuate that with a silver Sharpie or a Molotow pen. And I'm not going to have to worry about busting those off. We got all the detail we need on there. And then you can see there's actually a groove in there for those photo etched pieces. Down in there, you'll see that. We've got our pump unit, which I'm glad is an individual piece to go on the frame because this is all metal. It's all chrome and aluminum, stainless. So I'm glad that that's a separate piece with all of its controls and little gauges and everything on the side. We'll be able to hand detail that and assemble it. And finally, the cab. The cab with its marker lights is one piece. That's great. Once again, we'll get that painted. We can highlight that with a marker. We got our windshield frame, side glass, handles molded in, and our little vents and everything. You can see we'll be doing a lot of work with a Sharpie and a Molotow pen, all of our chrome trim, all that cool stuff on there. Be mounting in our headlights, panel lines, and then we have a nice panel line along here that we can work and cut to do our two-tone paint. Thankfully, on this LaFrance, everything else is metal, so we can hand paint that or mask and paint. And then the cab itself is two-tone, and we've got that nice striping decal to go all the way back. So I'm gonna start gluing mine together. And what you'll notice a little different in this one is I'll be using Tamiya Extra Thin. And the reason being, very, very small kit. I need a very small applicator. So that's what I'll be using. This is available from hobby retailers like modelroundup.com or anything like that. I could always use my Plastruct Bondine, and I'm sure I will, but the applicator brushes on these and the other jars I use for it are quite large. So I'm gonna use my Extra Thin on this one. Give me a smaller applicator. I won't get as much gunk on stuff. I'm gonna glue this little beauty together. For what I can, I'm going to cut the parts trees apart so I can get things painted, and I'll see you soon.
Thank you.
While fiddly and requiring attention and some tweezers because of the size, assembly is not difficult. Not difficult at all. In fact, I would still say it's easier than the older AMT fire engine kits by far. So we've got the frame assembled, the chassis assembled, and holy cow, look at the detail on that little thing. I mean, that is outstanding, right? We've got our photo etch, which I will be painting and then attaching later, right up there, like that. So we got that nice diamond plate there. We've got the front axle in place. We've got the springs and shock system in place. Check this out. It's even got the bags for the air brakes on the front and rear. It's got the drain for the differential. I mean, they've really gone through and done a beautiful job with all the air tanks and pump fittings to run the pumps and all that stuff. We've got the pump installed there. I did glue it on to make sure it mated properly with that coupling there, but I can paint it by hand. Won't be a problem. Main chassis color is all going to be black anyways. Then I will accentuate the fuel tank and paint like the pump and, you know, the PTO for the pump and all that stuff. Some of these side tanks I will paint by hand, and I will just enjoy myself. The axles for the rear are glued in, so be super, super careful when you put your wheels on, when you put your duals together. Otherwise, we should be all set to go. That front axle locks into place, and we can detail it from there, paint it up. We have our interior tub. Did nothing with that. Just cut the tree off so I can hold it and get it painted. We've got our pumper body and our hose storage with the photo etch here, and it's all standing up along the side. Takes a little bit. I use super glue. Model glue, of course, is not going to hold brass. Brass is a metal. Super glue or model glue only holds plastic to plastic because it melts together. So I use super glue in there with some activator. Put the sides on. I did leave the door open. The separate door is right here, so we'll paint that body color. I left that open to show those tanks. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get in there and paint those or not. We'll find out. If I can't, I can seal the door. If not, I can mount it so the door is open. You know, it all depends. And then we've got our tarps here. All of our equipment on the side, our rigid lines and stuff like that. And then our ladder is going to hang there, cover some of that up. But we got all of our doors and everything on our pumper body. It is crucial to use primer on photo etch parts because they are brass. They're not going to accept a lot of paints by themselves, so primer will help cling on to it. Then we've got the actual pump mechanism with all of its gauges and hoses. We've got our step plates at the bottom of either side glued in, and we've got our water cannon with its mount all mounted in there, and the hose right there. So we do have that stuff all in there. I can reach in and hand paint all of that. This is going to be all metallic with some red details and some off tan green details for the hose in there. Otherwise, full metallic body on this. And then we'll go in and detail and black wash and see if we can make the switches look kind of neat and all that on there. On the cab, what I have to do is I'm going to mask off along that line right there using my washi tape, and then we will get this painted. So I'll mask it off, come up over the diamond plate on the back and down, or you can paint it because diamond plate does get painted sometimes. So we can go all the way across there and the nose, and then paint this red. So when I have this masked, I will prime this and then paint it red, same as I'll prime this to get it red. And I will black prime and paint the interior and the chassis. We've got our seats ready to go. We've got our regular cushion back seats. And I'm assuming these seat backs are open to allow room for their air tanks and equipment on the back. That's why those would be open. We've got the dashboard done with its steering wheel, its steering column, and even has the gear shift on the side. Because a lot of these are full auto now. They just put it into gear and drive it. They usually don't have to know how to drive a manual transmission or a 9-speed anymore that were in these trucks. So that's pretty cool. And then we'll get this painted up in the gray, same as the seats that they want. We've got our ladder, our wheel set, and our exhaust. We will get those painted up in a metallic tone. And then the rest of these parts are all accessories and equipment. We got a plate of diamond plate. We've got some steps. We've got front bumper equipment, sirens. We got a bell. So I'm just going to paint that all metallic as well on that tree. I'll prime it and then paint it. I'm going to get all that stuff over to color right now. Thank you. I'm getting down to all the brass tacks now. I've got things detailed, painted, glued together. Now what I need to do is start attaching things to the chassis, put the interior into the cab, attach that, and then I've got some very small detail parts. We've got mirrors, we've got line equipment, we've got some pumps, we've got sirens, we've got some overhead light systems, we've got caps on the axles, we've got the wigwags for the top of the cab that I've done in the red over the clear. We have to attach the interior. That's what I did. That's just two different shades of gray. And then I black washed the instrument panel and the dashboard. Glued the steering wheel in, so the dash and the steering wheel and the seats are in the light gray. The equipment rack I did with a silver Sharpie. And that's set to go up inside the cab. We've got the cab done. Glass is glued in. Got all of our chrome details all the way around. Did our red lights and our amber lights on there. Got our cab marker lights on the top. That was done by using a silver Sharpie and then an orange Sharpie over the top of it. So we're all set. All the stuff that mounts on front of the cab, on the side of the cab, has holes to mount them. Same as the railings and everything on the back of the cab. So it's amazing on a kit this small, and then you look at a modern kit and they won't have location holes for anything. Very, very interesting what one company can do and what other companies decide not to do. Not that they can't do it, they just decide not to. So I've got the large operating pump here. We've got the steps on there. It's just still attached to the sprue because it's from the bottom, so I can just remove it, and this helped me hold it and get it painted. We've got the hose reel on top, and then I did a black wash inside there. I did it with a brass nozzle, and then the steel and red housing. Did all of our buttons and gauges. There are gauge decals, but they're white. They don't show up as nice as doing it with a little black wash in there. On the other side, I just used a thin line marker to accentuate the panel line, same as I did on the service body. And then we're going to be installing on these holes. And these holes, once everything's on the frame, we've got some smaller pump and fitting to go on there and finish it. On this one, I glued the large piece of diamond plate on the top. We painted in that diamond plate, then we sprayed it so we get an even coat. Then I did the red lighting and did some black washing for the steps on there. Did some washing on the side with the fire extinguishers and the trim and the Molotow trim on the bottom. So it looks nice. And then what I did with those rolls of fabric on the side was I painted them with a flag red and a Tuscan red craft paint and then gray washed in there with the Tamiya gray wash. And that lets us see that those are fabric. And when we're all set, our ladder also will be hanging on the side. So, and then we have our rigid lines on there that I did with the Molotow as well. So it's coming out super nice. I've got the frame done. I dry brushed it because in this scale, it's, you know, anything black is going to really get washed out. So I dry brushed the whole chassis with a metallic gray. It's a gunmetal gray craft paint. Got our pump housing. The wheel and tire package is outstanding. Something you wouldn't know. It actually has drive tires and steer tires on a kit this size. Look at the tread patterns. And they come in. They come four tires for the drive, two for the steer, and they're in separate bags. That's just, I don't see that in any of the kits being produced for trucks nowadays. But this little tiny one, Trumpeter went and did that, so that's pretty crazy. Awesome looking wheels. The holes stayed open with spray paint.
Well, you're never going to see those again if you use spray paint. You got to use an airbrush, and you got to thin it, and you got to buy the paints from this exact factory.
Look at that. All the holes are still wide open. They look great, and I used spray. I used a $1.99 can of True Color spray paint. So we've got to attach the little pieces. Then we've got to go and do all the decals on the kit, and we've got to attach that cover of diamond plate on the front bumper that I primed and sprayed. When I get all that done, I will give it a coat of Future Floor Polish to shine it up, let it dry, and we'll have the final. And now we wrap up. my build of the all new, all completely new from top to bottom, Trumpeter 1/72 scale American LaFrance Eagle Fire Pumper. One thing I want to say is I loved this kit. You may not build in 1/72 scale, but holy cow, I rarely do as well. I built some armor kits and really enjoyed them from Model Rectifier Corporation. And this one that they released from Trumpeter in the US is magnificent. And I hope to see in other Model Rectifier highlights that they will be distributing more of these. I want to see Trumpeter make more fire engines, more other cool vehicles in this scale, because not only was it a fun build, but surprisingly extremely well detailed. It went together very well. We got to show you the using photo etch parts, and I don't mind tapping it. It's definitely strong enough. It's not a fragile little flower. It's got perfect wheels. It's got drive and steer tires. I mean, come on. Photo etched detail, such as all the diamond plate. We've got microscopic detail in the light bars, the water pumps, the hoses, the outlets for the giant pumper body. We've got even the mirror over the front so they can see down the nose and around the corner. The side mirrors, all the holes are pre-molded in the body for you to mount everything. You don't have to sit and drill holes. You don't have to fiddle with anything. And it's got a complete chassis with axles and pumper housing, even though you won't see it. It's all underneath there. We've shown it before. They've got blanket detail, separate ladder, individual glass, wiper blades, all in this small scale. I mean, there's my dental tool. Here is my metallic ruler, my machinist ruler. Look at that thing. That is awesome, and I just love it. And these don't take up a lot of shelf space. They have more than enough detail. I'd like to see Trumpeter or anyone else come out with this in 1/25th, or most likely if it's from a company like Trumpeter overseas, it'd be 1/24th, but more modern fire vehicles, airport fire trucks, all that, either in 1/72 or in 1/24th scale like they would produce. You could even have the same number of parts because this thing is super detailed. So if you had 1/24th scale, you could add a little bit more parts, but you wouldn't need to make it pedantic and over detailed and complicated. This is, I'm just so surprised. I'm glad that Model Rectifier sent this over. This is super pleasing. I will link into the description where you can snag yours. And remember, when you buy direct from Model Rectifier Corporation, they will provide parts support for the Trumpeter kits, which most other distributors will not. They will tell you to go to direct to Trumpeter. Then you get to deal with the language barrier and all that stuff. So Model Rectifier wanted you to know that they provide parts support for the kits they sell. And that is a wonderful thing. The decals laid down without issue. I used a Mr. Mark's softer decal solution. There's also numerous other ones out there like Tamiya brand. I don't know how it works with the US-based decal solvent, the Microscent Microsol, but I can tell you the ones that I have on the bench work absolutely fine without issue. They lay down. I mean, some are super small, but they don't destroy. We've got the white, gold, and black striping along the bottom. I did notice that the white, being such a thin, beautiful decal, did allow some of the red to come through. But these decals are first rate. Did you know there is a clear spacing in each one of these decals along the side for the door seams, for the toolboxes? I didn't put those seams in there. They're on the decals. All right, and they even sink into the cargo door back there. Really, really fun. This blew my mind. I thought it was going to be oversimplified. This kit took my full 2 days as usual, but did not give me fights or fits or anything. I love modern tooling. It was a lot of fun. So get yours, and the more of these you pick up, the more they will probably release. I could see all kinds of work vehicles in this scale. How about a ladder truck with steerable trailer? How about a regular fire engine with, you know, not just a pumper, but the other style fire engines, modern vehicles, airport fire support, military fire support. Let's get some other kits of municipal work vehicles, some dump trucks, some backhoes, some excavators, bulldozers. Man, I'm just getting beyond myself. I would love to have a whole collection of this detail of a kit, this much fun, that doesn't take up 2 feet of shelf space. And if they wanted to do 1/24th scale, I'd get those too, because this was unbelievably enjoyable to build. So thanks for watching the workshop. Hope you're enjoying your Saturday. We should be back on Wednesday. I'm going to try to get back into the 2 per week. Life gets in the way sometimes, and I wasn't able to, but hopefully I can get back to doing 2 videos a week. I want to thank you all for your support. I want to thank Model Rectifier for sending this over. I want to thank Trumpeter for designing and building a gorgeous all-new kit. We don't see a lot of new stuff anymore, and this is awesome. So I will be back with another review soon, and thanks for watching HPI Guys Workshop. Hello everybody, and welcome to HPI Guys Model Workshop. We are going to be building up the brand new, all new molds, nothing recycled, the